Searching for the secrets of the cosmos? They're buried in the ice. Telescopes aren't just for making pretty pictures. Ever since we invented the optical telescope back in the 1600s, we've been able to expand human perception beyond its natural boundaries and reshape the way we view reality. Skip ahead about 400 years, and the Hubble Space Telescope is still reshaping our way of looking at the universe. For one thing, it taught us that the age of the universe is somewhere between 13 and 14 billion years. It also showed us the ultra-deep field, a look at the unbelievable flaming galaxies that filled the sky 1 billion years after the universe formed. Telescopes are like keyholes through which we see the secrets of the universe. One of those secrets is the neutrino, a tiny little particle. But it's not your typical subatomic particle. For one thing, it's formed in nuclear reactions that happen in the core of the sun or more distant stars. When it's generated, it flies off and pretty much doesn't stop. It's not affected by magnetic fields, it can pass straight through objects, and scientists believe that by studying it, we might be able to learn more about the mysterious dark matter that makes up a large portion of our universe. Now, scientists at the Ice Cube Telescope have found a particularly interesting way to try and study neutrinos. They buried 5,000 optical sensors a mile or more beneath the surface of the ice at the South Pole, rather than erecting a telescope in an observatory. You might say they did the polar opposite of what you expected, because it's the South Pole. All right, but why are they looking in the ice? At that depth, the pressure pushes out all the air bubbles in the ice, making it crystal clear so those sensors can detect neutrino activity. It's also really dark a mile down from the surface. That's important because when a neutrino interacts with an atom inside the ice, it gives off a faint blue light called Cherenkov light. Now, that interaction also produces another subatomic particle called a muon, and here's where things get crazy. The scientists can look at the direction that muon travels and measure the intensity of the light given off and work backwards to determine the origin of that neutrino. It's kind of like a cop determining where a shooter stood by looking at bullet holes that are in a wall. Now, that's not the only way we're looking at distant objects in the near future. We're also launching the James Webb Space Telescope sometime around 2018. This telescope is going to carry lots of different instruments, including the NearCam. Now, this creates something called a coronagraph. It's looking for faint objects in the universe as they pass in front of brighter objects, you know, like a planet passing in front of its star. Then there's the NearSpec, which is short for spectrograph. This creates a frequency spectrum on a detector material, and it's sort of like a cosmic fingerprint that's unique to that specific object. Now, scientists can look at this frequency spectrum and determine an object's mass, its temperature, even its chemical composition. It's a pretty far jump from the optical telescopes that Galileo was using way back in the 1600s. But the technology we use today is going to uncover future discoveries that will continue to reshape our view of the universe. Who knows, we might see the mysteries of dark matter or evidence of alien life, or maybe even the next Earth. Now that leads me to a question for all of you this week. What mysterious object out in the universe do you think is the one we should be concentrating on first? Let me know in the comments below. Explain your answer. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit like. Join our army of futurists by subscribing to the channel. And after all of that hard work, reward yourself. Watch one of these awesome videos over here.